Today I'm going to show off the Sanity Connect application. This video will highlight taking content you have within Sanity and syncing it over into Shopify. This lets you use the full range of Shopify's native tooling for building custom storefronts that update in real time from changes that you're making within Sanity. To start with, I'm working on a store that I've already configured to use the Sanity Connect application. And to make things easy, I'm going to be working off sample schemas provided by Sanity's default e-commerce template and sample products that Shopify provides for development. And this shows that it doesn't take much customization to get things working. So in the Sanity Studio over here on the right, I'll walk you through my customizations. The first change is here in the structure navigation. I've created a new document type to represent custom landing pages. And I'll use each document here to represent a page that highlights my brand in a different location. And a little bit later, I'll revisit this content. For now, I'm going to dive into my products. So all of the default Shopify fields are syncing over in this tab over here. And this is the stuff that's natively available in Shopify's interface. But I've also created a custom field that I want to use in my store. And this I'm going to use to help me categorize my snowboards, which I'm selling based on their style. So to get this data into Shopify, I'm going to head over to the Shopify admin in Sanity Connect, and I will turn on Sync Content from Sanity to Shopify. Now, when I save this configuration and update the permissions, I'm going to have some new tabs available at the top of my page. The first is the Metafields tab. This shows the custom fields that we're syncing on the native Shopify objects, so products, product variants, and collections. And this table is going to be useful for showing us each field that was found and the data type for each. The data type is inferred automatically based on the data that we receive in running a sync. Now, right now I've only got custom fields on the core product object type, so that's the only one that I'm seeing. Also, the data here is just about native Shopify objects. So to see the full range of document types that we've defined in Sanity, I'll visit this metaobjects tab. For Sanity Connect, we're not going to sync over everything by default so that you can opt into just the document types that you want to sync. I've got my landing page selected, so now let's switch into using my content. So the first thing I want to do is show you where the raw data is that we're syncing into Shopify. So using Shopify's command palette, I can jump into the meta objects for my store. So here I can see the different object types that are syncing in, and then for each, I can dive into each individual entry. This view is a really good place to go first if you're unsure about what has synced from Sanity. We can see the same information for my products, but for products, we're going to be looking for meta fields. So to see that, I'll head to my product page and head a little bit further down, and there's a meta fields section. When I view all and then view at meta fields, I can see the fields that we're syncing over from Sanity. And so you can see, for example, the style field matches my freestyle that I have synced over from Sanity. Now I can also update this information in the Sanity Studio and publish. And then when I head over into the Shopify admin and refresh the page, I just see my new field as well. So now this snowboard is listed as a beginner. Even though this data typically syncs over right away, you should remember that there are actually many layers of caching throughout your storefront. So it may take a few moments for category changes like this to impact live collections that you've published. So now that I've seen that we've got our data in Shopify, I want to start using these tools. So the meta fields and meta objects that we're syncing can be used across Shopify's platform. And as a developer, I can access them in Liquid and the Storefront API. So for this demo, I want to stay in the Shopify admin and create a new collection first. I'll create a new collection. I'll call this Beginner Boards. And I'll say I want to create an automated collection based on a field. And so on my product, if I scroll down a little bit, I can see the meta fields and the style field that I'm pulling over on my snowboards. I'll say I want to match anything that is beginner, and I'll save. Now, right away, I can see the snowboards that have matched this collection, which is great. I can use this right away. So the next thing I want to do is I want to jump into my visual theme editor, and I'm going to use this to display what we're syncing over. So I'll customize my theme. Since we've added a new field on my product, let's update that theme. I'll add a new text block and move it up a bit, and I'll customize it. And I'll say that I want to display my style field, And for that, I can dynamically link it to the style meta field that's sort of my product. And so right away, you can see that this 3P fulfilled snowboard that we're looking at is a beginner board, just like we've seen in our collection and in the studio. So this is just for my products. But the other thing that I can do is I can create new pages for my meta objects. So down here at the bottom, you can see my meta objects like the landing page object, and I can create a new template for those. Pulling up the same landing page in the studio, we can start customizing. So let's add a new section, like a rich text section, and I'll start customizing it. And up here for the title, I'll replace that with a reference to the title from my Sanity document. And for simple number and text fields, I can link these right in the editor, no problem. But I've also got more complex fields like this description field. This is a portable text field in Sanity. And that we can't link right away, but we can by using Liquid. So in order to use Liquid in your storefront, you'll have to import a bunch of snippets that we have provided in the portable text to Liquid code base. And I've done this step already in my store. So what I'm gonna do next is referencing the snippets that I have already synced over, I'm gonna copy and paste in a simple Liquid command. That's gonna tell me I wanna render using the portable text snippet that I've synced over, referencing the description field on my meta object. And now it's pulling in that content right away, displaying the header, the text, and the bullets, just as I've described them over in Sanity. And with that, I'm done. There's honestly a whole lot more that you can create when you individualize this for your store and your own products, but I hope that this gives you a really good foundation to build on.